So in the previous class, we discussed about the depletion region, Wheat and the equilibrium. Okay, we also discussed about the electric field magnitude as well as the built-in potential that is developed across the depletion region. Okay, so for a PN junction, the width of the depletion region can be given by this formula: W equal to 2 epsilon s, permittivity divided by Q, 1 upon NF plus 1 upon ND into BVI. Okay, so P side doping NA, N side doping ND, VVI the built-in voltage and permittivity. If these parameters are known, then we can find out the total width of the depletion region. Okay, the peak of the electric field was also obtained. The peak of the electric field was given by this formula. It is QNA upon epsilon s into XP or QND upon epsilon s into XN. Okay, and the peak of the electric field is at the junction, metallurgical junction. Okay, it was very much expected as the most of the field lines will pass through this point. In fact, all the field lines that will emerge from the N site of the depletion region will pass through this particular position and will be terminating to the negative charges of the P side of the depletion region. Okay, and the electric field everywhere is shown as a negative here. As you can see, this is because the direction of the electric field is from right to left. Okay, and the depletion width formula for two sided junction can be simplified to get the depletion width formula for a one sided junction. In the previous class, we discussed that in one sided junction, the doping of one side of the PN junction will be significantly higher than that of the other side, so that the depletion region width of the higher doping side can be neglected compared to the other side depletion width. Okay, so if you consider P plus N junction, then the XP can be neglected compared to XN, and in this case we get a simplified formula for the depletion width. Okay, it is because in case of one sided junction, we can actually neglect this 1 upon NA compared to 1 upon ND if the doping is higher towards the P side. Okay, so the modified for simplified formula, in fact, for the depletion width for one sided junction turns out to be this: W equal to XN 2 epsilon s by Q 1 upon ND into VBI. Okay, the electric field also the electric field distribution in one sided junction, the same equation that was derived for the two sided junction, I mean for the PN junction which has comparable doping on either side, that can be simplified in order to get the field distribution. And the field in the N side depletion region is similar to that what was there even in the previous case. Okay, and similarly the potential variation is also similar to the general case. Okay, and the formula can be derived for the potential variation in the N side of the depletion region Because the electric field simplified expression for the electric field is known here, and we can integrate the field, okay, from 0 to x. We can get the area under the field curve, and we can get the potential potential function. Okay, so the potential function is obtained here. A general expression for the potential function for the one-sided junction is Vvi upon W into x multiplied by 2 minus xyw. Okay, so we discuss these derivations in the previous class. Okay, now we will go back to the band model of PN junction, and we will look at the things, how the energy band diagram is going to change when the equilibrium is broken and some steady state excitation is applied to the PN junction. Okay. So the here you can see this PN junction is shown under equilibrium in the first picture A. There is a P side, N side, and in between the depletion width is there. And the energy band diagram is also drawn here as expected. We have already discussed it because it is under equilibrium. So the electric field is to be constant everywhere. And so the Fermi level is to be constant everywhere. And to account the presence of electric field in the depletion region, there is a band bending here, and the total bending is equal to Q times VVI, which is where the VVI is the built-in voltage. So energy equivalent is Q times VVI, and we also discuss why this bending is in this particular fashion, because N side is positively charged, okay, and P side is negatively charged. So the potential polarity is actually positive towards the N side, and compared to N side, P side, it will have higher potential, the N side edge. So that's why this bending is in this particular fashion. But the two things that is important to be noted: the Fermi level is consistent throughout; it is a constant, okay, and flat from the neutral P region to depletion region to N region. Okay, and the total bending here is QVBI, which is equal, which is determined by the built-in potential that is developed across the depletion region. Okay, now the depletion region width, if there is a excitation applied, steady state excitation, in fact, here between the two terminals of the diode, a potential, so battery is connected here. You can see the VF is connected. Okay, so you can see here the in the first picture, the P side is kept at the higher potential than the N side, which is the so-called the forward bias condition in the PN junction. And in forward bias condition, you know that the current increases exponentially. Okay, so here is the IV characteristics of a PN junction, and especially for the forward bias, you can see that the there is a exponential relation between the current and voltage. So for a small change in the voltage, huge current will flow. Okay, whereas in the reverse bias, the applied potential is negative. It means that the cathode is kept at higher potential than the anode. Just 1 minute. Okay, can you see the slides properly? Any one of you, can you confirm it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the forward bias condition is shown here in figure B, where the P side is kept at higher potential with the help of this battery. So there is a steady state excitation, because this potential is constant, it's not changing with respect to time. Okay, and similarly, in the figure C, you can see that the biasing is reversed. It means now the N side is kept at the higher potential than the P side. So we would like to know what will be the impact of this applied potential on the depletion width, and the two tendencies, the drip tendencies and the diffusion tendencies of the carrier that were at the equilibrium, that were actually cancelling to each other under the thermal equilibrium condition. So is this going to, is that balance is going to be disturbed, or similar as the case of equilibrium. Okay, so to understand this energy band diagram in forward bias condition, where the anode is at the higher potential than the cathode, you can see, if you look at the energy band diagram, its shape is similar as that of the thermal equilibrium case. Okay, okay, let me use this. Okay, so under thermal equilibrium, the energy band diagram was like this. EF is the Fermi level, and there is a variation in EC like this. Okay, and then there is a variation in EF like this. EV like this. So this is EC and EV, and this is EF. Okay, and this is the depletion region, and the total bending is equal to Q time VBI. This was equal to Q time VBI. Okay, when the PN junction is kept in forward bias, P side and N side, this P side is kept at higher potential than the N side. And let us say that this potential V is applied. Okay, so under equilibrium, there was a depletion region here across the junction. Okay, it was spread more in N side, let us say. So this was the width of the depletion region in equilibrium. Okay, so when this potential V is applied, okay, and you can see that the polarity is this. This terminal is positive compared to this terminal because of this additional potential. Okay, and in forward bias, you know that there is a current, there will be current flowing through the device, PN junction device. Okay, and this P region is outside this depletion region, the P side is neutral. So the conductivity of this P region is actually high. Okay, similarly, the conductivity of this N region will also be high compared to the depletion region. Okay, so as the conductivity of this P side is high, then as the current is flowing through this, so we can consider that the potential drop in this region is quite small. Okay, it's negligible compared to potential difference across this depletion region. And whatever this additional potential is applied between the two terminals, anode and cathode, that is going to appear across the depletion region. So this V is actually going to appear here like this. Okay, And at the same time, if you recall the built-in potential, the polarity of the built-in potential was like this. So this edge was at positive potential, the N side edge of the depletion region, and the P side edge of the depletion region was at the, I mean, this was the polarity of the potential, which was equal to VBI. Okay. So this potential V that is appeared across the depletion region because of this external source, this potential V is going to oppose this built-in potential. So the effective potential across the depletion region now turns out to be VBI minus V. Okay. And in forward bias case, the forward bias potential is quite small. Okay, so at the moment we are considering that this V, the applied external potential, is smaller than this built-in potential VBI, because this is the models we'll be developing later on will be for the low level of carrier injection. So this is one of the requirement for that. Okay, so if the external potential here V is opposing this VBI, okay, then the net potential across the depletion region is VBI minus V, and you know that the depletion region width is proportional to square root of VBI. Okay, so now in place of the VBI, the depletion width can be given as it becomes proportional to VBI minus this capital V. Okay. So, because of this external potential, the external forward bias potential, the width of the depletion region is also going to decrease. As the potential across the depletion region decreases, the width of this potential region is also going to, width of this depletion region is also going to decrease. Okay. So, this is actually shown here in energy band diagram. This is reflected in the energy band diagram. You can see here. Okay. So now the total banding is, what is this show? Okay. So here, across the depletion region, the net potential is VBI minus capital V, and therefore the total drop here in the energy level is Q time VBI minus VF. Unlike the previous case, under equilibrium case where this bending was Q time VBI, you note here, it is Q time VBI minus VF. Okay. And you will also notice another important point here. You will see that the Fermi level is no more consistent. Okay, the Fermi level is now broken. Okay, in equilibrium case, there is a single Fermi level throughout. It's a flat level from P side to N side. Okay, and in forward bias case, however, what you see that the Fermi level is splitted. Now the P side Fermi level is different from the N side Fermi level, and this difference in the two Fermi levels is actually equal to Q time V the potential, external potential that has been applied between the two terminals. Okay, you can see that this splitting is in the Fermi level is because of the external bias potential Vf. Okay, and this difference is going to be Q time Vf. So why is this splitting observed here under forward bias condition? Can you answer this?
Sir, due to potential difference, more number of carriers are being produced.
Good.
So in P side, more holes are generated, and in N side, more electrons, free electrons are being generated. So that is why.
Yes. So you are thinking in that line actually. So as the barrier height is reduced here, in this case you see that the barrier, first case it was Q time VBI, now the barrier has been reduced, it is Q time VBI minus VF. Okay, and because of the higher barrier here in thermal equilibrium, the diffusion was actually tendency was balanced by the drip tendency and the net current was zero. But in this case, as the barrier height has been reduced, now the diffusion tendency is going to dominate over the drip tendency, because you can see, since the energy here, EC, in this case, let's say in the equilibrium, if let's say that this was the charge distribution, okay, mobile charge distribution in the neutral ion region, okay, it was like this, it has a certain height. But this was being, these carriers were not able to move through this junction, okay. And similarly, there were holes here, and those holes will also see this potential barrier and they will be unable to move actually, okay. They will be unable to surmount this barrier and they won't move, okay, from the P side to N side, okay. But as the barrier height has been reduced as the in the under forward bias condition, as depletion region decreases, the width of the depletion region decreases, the barrier height reduces, and when the barrier height reduces, the same height of, let's say, the same distribution of the carrier will be like this now, okay. Their height remains same, and if the height remains same, now there will be few carriers that won't see this potential barrier. They will be comfortable to cross this potential barrier, and they will enter into the N side, P side. And similarly, the holes here, because of this reduced barrier, some holes will be able to move towards the N side. Okay, and therefore there will be excess carriers generated on the either side of the depletion region. Here in this case, the holes will be the excess carriers, excess minority carriers in the N side. So there will be hole accumulation here near the at the edge of the depletion region towards N side. There will be electron accumulation here, because electrons have been injected from N side to P side. So the minority carrier concentrations are actually get modified, and therefore the same Fermi level now cannot be able to address the carrier concentration in the P region and N region. Okay, so that's why the Fermi levels has to be split now, and there will be two different Fermi level. The EFP will be towards P side and EFN will be towards N side. Okay, and let us say that this EFP will be constant till the edge of the depletion region, and similarly the EFN here will be constant till the edge of near the, let us say, till the edge of this depletion region. Till this edge of the depletion region. So this is EFN and this is EFP. Okay. In the depletion region, it will be a little bit complicated. We'll discuss that later on, a little bit later on. Okay. So the another observation is, however, in this picture I have shown that the EFP is below the EFN. Why is this? Any one of you? Why did I not draw the either way, EFP above EFN by the same amount, Q time capital V, Q time VF. Can any one of you answer this? You can answer this in the same line as we have discussed the band bending in presence of when we are talking about the drift phenomena. Okay, then when we applied electric field, okay, I mean potential difference between the two edges of the sample, okay, there was a band bending. And there we discuss which side will be at the lower energy and which one will be at the higher energy. Okay, so here you can see the there is a positive P side is at the higher potential, okay, than N side. Okay, so potential energy for the electrons will be less towards the P side. All right, so that's why the P side, the side which will have which will be at the higher potential, that will have lower energy. Okay. So this EFP is lower than EFN by the amount Q time VB, Q time VF. Is it clear? Anybody? Any question?
Sir, can you repeat
the
question?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So you mean to say that the potential is lesser at P side than N side? That is why that is.
Okay, just let me refresh this. Okay, let me open this slide of unit 2. Okay, all right, recall it. Okay, so there was a N here, N type semiconductor, and this side V. This side was kept at higher potential. Okay, so Fermi level of this side is lower than the opposite side. Okay, because here the positive potential is connected. So therefore you can see the side which will have higher potential that will go lower in on the energy scale. Okay, so that's why the EF is low here this side, and EF will be higher this side. So the similar argument can be applied over there too. If you see that if the two sides are grounded, no potential difference, energy levels are flat. Okay, EF is flat. But here, as there is a potential difference between the two terminals, current will flow. So if the current will flow means the Fermi level DF, DEF by DX, okay, cannot be zero. It means there will be slope in the Fermi level over the space, okay, and that's why this EF has got a finite slope here, and the side which is at the higher potential has lower energy. Okay, is it clear now? So the same argument can be used here. Okay, so this bending, this is splitting in the Fermi level is because of this VF. This is the driving force. Okay, and that's why here this side Fermi level, P side Fermi level is lower than the N side Fermi level. Okay, although there will be even splitting in this EFP and this EFN, there will be splitting in EFP towards this depletion region, and in EFN again towards the depletion region, but we'll discuss that later on. At the point here, the region of this splitting is this V, the VF, okay, and this is the particular, this is the way this splitting happen. Okay, EF goes lower than EF P goes lower than this EFN. Okay. All right. And similarly, in the reverse bias, you can see in the reverse bias, when the anode is at the lower potential than the cathode, it means here the VR potential is connected between the cathode terminal and the anode terminal. Okay, so this VR is going to again appear across this depletion region. This is one of the assumptions you see that the potential drop in the neutral region is very small. Although it will be small but finite, but for the sake of simplifying this analysis, it is being assumed that it is almost zero. Okay. However, it will be significant enough to cause the drift of the carriers in the neutral P side and neutral N side. Okay. But the assumption here is the entire VR will appear across this depletion region, okay, and this is going to be the polarity of this potential VR, and this is in phase with the built-in potential VVI. Okay, so now two gets added, so the total potential across the depletion region turns out to VVI plus VR. Okay, so the potential drop across the depletion region increases, and therefore the width of the depletion region increases. Okay, and once the width of the depletion region increases, then there will be more banding across the depletion region, as you can see here, and the banding is again equal to Q time VVI plus VR. The banding in the conduction band is equal to Q time VVI plus VR. Okay, which is the total potential drop across the depletion region. But the Fermi levels will again split here. Okay, you can see the EFP is here and EFN is here. Okay, EFN is here. Fermi level splitting happens, and this splitting, the two levels are again separated by this potential Q time VVR, because this VVR was responsible for this splitting in the Fermi level. Okay, and the same argument you can also apply, which side will be at the higher energy level, which one will be at the lower energy level, because now the VR, the N side is at the higher potential than the P side. Okay, so N side Fermi level will go down than the P side Fermi level. Okay, so that's why you see here EFN is lower than EFP, unlike the previous case where EFP was lower than EFN. Okay, so please note that the splitting in the Fermi level will be related with the external bias voltage. It will not be this is not equal to Q time VVI plus VR. This is equal to only Q time VR. Okay, whereas the bending in the Fermi level, bendings in the valence level, conduction level, and the intrinsic level will be equal to Q time VVI plus VR. Okay. All right. So now it is clear that under forward bias condition, the width of the depletion region decreases. Okay. And under reverse bias condition, the width of the depletion region increases. And if you also look at the two tendencies of the carrier flow, so in the forward bias PN junction, now the diffusion is going to dominate over the drift, because what was the reason behind the drift? The electric field in the depletion region. Okay, so electric field now decreases, peak of the electric field will decreases across the depletion region in forward bias junction. Okay, and this electric field was the driving force for the drifting of the minority carriers. Okay, because of this field, electric field, the electrons were moving from minority electrons were moving from P side to N side, and minority holes were moving from P side to N side. So since this electric field is B, now less carrier will drift from electron will drift from P to N side, and holes will drift from N to P side. So the drift current will now be small, okay, compared to the diffusion current, because the because of the lowered barrier height here, there will be a great tendency of the diffusion of the carrier through the depletion region. Lot of holes will move from P side to N side and from N side to P side. In fact, there will be exponential relation, okay, in the in between the excess carriers that are injected to either side and the potential bias voltage that is applied here. Okay, means there is a for very small change in VF, there will be huge change in the excess carriers across the depletion region, excess minority carriers across the depletion region. Okay, because the holes that will be injected from P side to N side, they becomes minority carrier here towards the N side. And similarly, the electrons that will be injected from N side to P side, they will become minority carriers in the P side. Okay, so there will be excess carriers and they will diffuse over a length. Okay, they will diffuse the average length LP. Okay, LN and LP. So the electrons will diffuse the excess average length over the average length LN. Some will actually travel larger than this, some will travel smaller than this, but the average length they will travel before the recombination is LN and LP respectively. Okay, so the carriers and the concentration of the excess carrier just at the junction is actually exponentially related with VF. So that's why when you increase the forward bias potential, okay, the current increases exponentially, because the excess carriers will increase exponentially on either side, and eventually those excess carriers will give rise to the diffusion current, which will form the total current of the PN junction. Okay, so under forward bias condition, the drift tendency will be dominated by the diffusion tendency, and the net current, the forward current which is shown here IF, it will be determined by the diffusion phenomena. Okay, the drift component now can be neglected compared to the diffusion current. All right, so minority drifting, drift of the minority carriers now can be neglected compared to this diffusion, and therefore the net current will be determined by this. Whereas in this case, opposite things will happen, because now the carriers distribution will remain same here, because the neutral region, there is no change in the neutral region. Okay, whatever you, whether you apply, there is no bias condition, or in forward bias condition, or in the reverse bias condition, the carrier concentration here remains same in the neutral region. Okay, so the carrier distribution over the energy will also remain same. In this case, if this is the energy increasing up, going up towards C, and this is the carrier distribution over energy, so this remains same as it was in this case, it was in the equilibrium case, or it is in the forward bias case. Okay, and similarly here, the whole concentration whole distribution will remain same. Okay, and as this barrier has been increased significantly, VVI plus VR, so the no chances of now the carrier injection from this side to this side. And you can see that the diffusion tendency gets weaker. Okay, it becomes very weak, very, very weak. Whereas as the electric field has been increased, the width of the depletion region has been increased. So the field is also strong now in the depletion region. And the region is, the VR could be quite high, larger than this capital V. Okay, so now the electric field is quite larger, and in that case the minority carriers, it means electron from P side to N side and hole from N side to P side, there will be significant movement of these carriers. Okay, and because of this significant movement, now the drift current will dominate over the diffusion current. Okay, so under the reverse bias condition, there will be current, but that current will be because of the that current will be dominated by the drift phenomena, not by the diffusion phenomena. Okay, and that's why you will see that the direction of the current will be opposite now. You can see that you just see the motion of the carriers. Okay, you just notice how these carriers are drifting across the depletion region. So minority electrons are moving from P side, okay, towards the right. It means they are giving rise to a current in this direction from right to left. Similarly here, the holes are moving from N side to P side and they are giving rise to current in this direction. So these two components get added and the net current will be from right to left. Okay. So this is the so-called reverse current IR. Okay. Whereas in the forward bias, it is the drift current, diffusion current that is going to dominate. And in the diffusion current, actually, the electrons are diffusing from N side to P side. Okay, so this will be this will give rise to a current which will be flowing from P side to N side. So this is IN, and the holes will be diffusing from P side to N side. So this will be giving rise to a current which will flow from left to right. Okay. And now the total current will be IN plus IP, and the direction of the current is from left to right. Okay, so under forward bias condition, you see that this is the direction IF, which is from left to right, and under the reverse bias condition, the current is IR, which is from right to left. Is it clear? And here IF is primarily because of the diffusion of the carriers. And IR is because of the drifting of the minority carriers across the depletion region. And that's why in magnitude, this IR is going to be very, very small compared to this IF. Okay? Is it clear? Any question from anybody? And here you can also notice in the expression of the depletion width, it gets modified. For under thermal equilibrium, it was 2 epsilon s by q into 1 upon nd multiplied by vbi. This has been modified now, made general equation for all bias condition. Now it is vbi minus v. So in equilibrium, v becomes 0. So it turns out to be 2 epsilon s upon q into 1 upon nd into vbi. Under forward bias condition, vbi minus vf. So this becomes smaller. So depletion width decreases. In reverse bias condition, this VBI, this becomes VBI plus capital V, VBI plus capital V, and this VR, and this because of the reverse bias voltage may be quite larger than VF, then this VBI plus V can be a significant value, and therefore the width of the depletion region increases under the reverse bias condition. Okay. So that is also shown here using the mathematical expression which was discussed using the energy band diagrams. Okay, and you can see that under forward bias case, the narrow depletion width is also shown here because this is the width of the depletion region where there is a bending, and in this case the bending is spread over a significant length. That's why this is the width, capital W. Okay, this is the W under forward bias case, this is W under the reverse bias case, which is much, much greater than the W of the forward bias case. Okay, any question from anybody?
Sir, here IR is less than IF because it is driven by minority carrier, right?
Yeah, and those carrier concentration is quite small. Okay, in diffusion these are excess carrier and their concentration will be quite large because their concentration will exponentially increase with the applied voltage Vf. So at lower Vf, even the forward current will be less, but when the Vf under forward bias condition is increased, the excess carrier concentration increases exponentially and therefore current increases exponentially. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Any other question?
Sir, sir, if we in the forward bias case, in P side, there are more number of holes.
Right.
But on N side, the number of holes decrease that constitute the current. So, if we consider that current is related to the drift velocity and drift velocity is somehow related to the kinetic energy.
In which case? Under reverse bias or forward bias?
Forward bias.
Okay. Under forward bias, the current is mainly constituted by the diffusion of the carriers across the depletion region. Diffusion. Okay. Not drift. Drift current will be small. Diffusion will dominate over the drift. Drift can be neglected under the forward bias condition. Okay. Similarly, the diffusion can be neglected under the reverse bias condition.
Can we say that the holes that were at P side, they were having some velocity, drift velocity, some velocity that is drift velocity due to which they constitute the current. But on N side, such holes with drift velocity decreased.
Right.
So it appear as if the holes either lost the energy or their energy has been converted to some other sort of energy other than kinetic energy.
No, thing is
what
that
is actually happening?
When the under forward bias condition, when the excess carriers are injected from P side to N side, okay. So when they are injected towards the N side, their concentration is excess carrier concentration will be higher at this depletion region and N region interface, and that concentration decreases when someone moves towards deeper into the N side. Okay, and this excess carrier delta Pn, let's say, which is significant here, but their concentration decreases like this. So because of this difference in as the concentration decreases, as the carriers will move towards right, they will be recombining. Okay, so there will be concentration gradient, because in equilibrium here the whole concentration is something smaller than the excess carrier concentration here at the junction. So because of this gradient, actually there will be the current, okay, diffusion current, getting it, and that diffusion current will actually assisted by the drift in the neutral region. So we'll discuss that in even greater detail when we'll talk about and when I'll be showing this graph. Actually, I will show you the exact distribution of the carriers and in which region transport mechanism is getting dominant, which will be responsible for the total current. Okay, so we'll talk this actually little bit later on. You can see the different current densities are shown. Okay, and what is the driving force, what is the reason behind this particular variation. Okay, that each and everything we'll talk about. Okay, so your question is actually a little bit advanced at this level. Once we'll be talking about this side, you will actually understand it. Okay, all those things will be covered when we'll be deriving the current expression. All right, so things are there actually in there to they will be coming very soon. Okay, here just my focus was to have a qualitative discussion so that you will understand actually how this tendencies, drift tendency and diffusion tendencies at the balance under equilibrium. But when either forward bias or reverse bias are applied, this equilibrium is broken and either of the tendency gets dominated over the other. Okay, this was the only purpose. And I hope that I have made this point clearly. All right. Any question from anybody? Right. All right, so now we'll move to another topic, which is before the deriving the current expression. Okay, that is one of the important topic of this unit. Okay, we'll discuss the use of the diode as a varector diode. Okay, this is a very, very important device and used for the tuning in the electronic circuits. Okay, so let us finish this today, and then in the next class we'll try to derive the drain current expression. Okay, so to discuss the before discussing the concept of the varector diode, let us talk about the depletion capacitance. So as you can see that under reverse bias condition, there is a wider depletion region, and this relation suggests here W equal to 2 epsilon S Q 1 by ND VI minus V square root of this, because under reverse bias this VR is negative, this becomes VVI plus VR, and even VR could be much larger than VVI. Okay, so under the condition this V is much VR, applied voltage is much larger than VVI, the W becomes proportional to square root of VR. Okay, so larger when we keep increasing the reverse bias voltage, the depletion width keeps on increasing. Okay, and what is the increase of the depletion region? The increase of the depletion region is basically the uncovering of more uncompensated ions. Okay, so you can see that under equilibrium, let's say not exactly an equilibrium, but this is a reverse bias condition. You can see the potential V is applied, and under at potential V, basically this is the scenario for the depletion region. Okay, depletion region towards the P side is this, and towards the N side is this. It's a wider, because let's say Na is greater than, slightly greater than Nd. Okay, but when we make an incremental change in the potential, let's say that now it has become V plus delta V, so some acceptor ions will be uncovered. More acceptor ions will be uncovered here, and similarly the more donor ions will be uncovered here. And what could be the possible reason for this? We have discussed that. Okay, because of that potential, the potential is increased, potential drop has been increased across the depletion region, and because of that some more charges has to be uncovered. Okay, so let us say that this is the dq towards the N side and minus dq towards the P side, because these are acceptor ions negatively charged and these are donor ion positively charged. So for an incremental change in dv, there will be incremental change in the charge dq. So we can define a depletion layer capacitance Cj, which is actually dq by dv. Okay, for incremental change in V potential, there is incremental change in the charge. Okay, so Cj is basically the depletion layer capacitance, or it is also called the junction capacitance sometimes. Junction capacitance. Okay, and its nature is quite similar to that of a parallel plate capacitor. Okay, in a parallel plate capacitor, when the potential difference, pardon? Any question?
Sir, we have another lecture.
Okay, at 6 p.m.
We have a class from this.
Pardon?
Yeah.
Actually, I couldn't get your question. Can you write your question so that I could answer that?
Sir, he is telling that we have lecture from sir.
He is saying.
Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. Then we will continue this. Okay. In tomorrow's class. No problem. Thank you. Thank you all.